Tips, tips, tips with Tony. Tips, tips, tips with Tony. All about nutrition from your favorite dietitian. Everything you need to digest in your mind. Tips, tips, tips with Tony. Tips, tips, tips with Tony. Making you healthier one bite at a time. With Tony, tips. With Tony, tips. With Tony. Woo.
Hello and welcome to the Tips with Tony podcast. I'm Tony Marinucci, your registered dietitian, helping you get healthy one bite at a time. Today we are talking about how to motivate yourself to do absolutely anything. Originally, I was going to talk about how to like pump yourself up to get your workout done and to motivate yourself to do that. But then I was going over like what it takes to motivate yourself to work out. I realized these tips could actually be utilized to motivate yourself to do literally anything. Okay. So the very first thing that you need to do to get yourself to go somewhere is you first need to visualize where you want to go. What is it that you want to do? You know, what sort of job do you want to apply for? What sort of workout do you want to accomplish? You know, what sort of tasks do you want to do? Like if you're motivating yourself, it could be as simple as doing your laundry, even though that sounds like really dreadful. But the best thing for you to do is to visualize yourself getting there. What does it feel like? What does it look like, right? So often we fixate on, I don't feel like working out. I'm so tired. I don't feel like doing the work. I'm so tired. I don't feel like doing the laundry. I don't want to do it. So as big as, you know, I want these big, I have these big goals and aspirations, and as small as like the little to-do list or the little task on your to-do list, I think it's really important that rather getting caught up in the moment of how we feel, we really need to visualize how we want to feel. What we want to look like, what we want to see, how we want to be. You know, when you really visualize it, when you visualize yourself being confident in the gym, lifting the weights, when you visualize yourself as the CEO of a company or the, you know, a principal of your school or whatever sort of thing you're trying to accomplish, or like the best mom that you want to be or whatever it is, if you visualize yourself there and really spend time, like 5 minutes, every morning, just thinking about how do you want to be, what do you want to look like, or even in the moment when you don't feel like working out, visualize yourself after the workout. You're sweaty, you feel good, you have energy, you feel strong. You know, visualize yourself 2 to 3 weeks out, visualize yourself 6 months. Imagine if you committed to 3 to 5 days a week of strength training or any sort of movement and you felt really good about that. What would you look like 3 months from now? What would you look like 6 months from now? Visualize that, hold that in your brain, hold that in your mind. And the more time you spend visualizing, the more clear the steps that you need to take to get there will start to appear. Okay. So visualize. If you get fixated, there's, you know, we say all the time, people, you know, you have to know why. Why do you want this? What's your goal? Why? The second you lose sight of your why is the second that you start to defer from your goals. That's where we start to self-sabotage. That's when we start to not take action towards what we want. That's when we get caught up in the moment. That's when we slip up. You know, that's often because we lost sight of why we wanted to make the change. You know, sometimes our brains will lie to us when we're tired, when we're stressed, when we're fatigued, when we're fed up, when we're frustrated, and just be like, nah, I don't want that anymore. I'm good. But that's not real. That's your tired brain. That's your frustrated brain. You know, that's your self-doubt brain, right? Sometimes we say we don't want it anymore because we don't believe that we can get it. I'm going to repeat that. Sometimes we say that we don't want it anymore because deep down we don't believe that we can get it. And that's because you lost sight of why it was important to you. You lost sight of the vision. And I need you to know right now that you are capable of accomplishing whatever you want in life. I'm going to go on a little bit of a tangent right now, but I hope you enjoy it. I am obsessed with America's Got Talent. I love all talent shows. I love singing shows. I love The Voice. I love American Idol. America's Got Talent is my absolute favorite show. Like, I'm so excited to watch it tonight. Like, you have no idea, I'm recording this right now. And I'm going to be watching it tonight, and I cannot wait to watch it. Why? Because it reminds me that you can do whatever you want to do. There are 80-year-old women who are dancing circles around. I could never dance like that, right? There are acrobatics. There are magicians that like just oh my God, the mind tricks. There are kids that are capable of training dogs and cats. They're like 5-year-old kids. They're literally like the most creative humans going after what they want, regardless of their age, regardless of their sex or gender, regardless of their ability. A lot of people who are disabled tend to go on these shows and just show you that, you know, just because they can't hear or just because they can't see doesn't mean they can't sing, doesn't mean they can't play the piano, doesn't mean they can't do acrobatics. There was one guy on the show who, him and his wife, they're called a dynamic duo or something, I forgot. They got all the way to the end, I think maybe 2 or 3 years ago. They are incredible, incredible at what they do. The husband, it's a husband and wife couple, the husband had no vision in his left eye. And so he was like flipping her through the air, jumping through the air, doing all these things with literally no vision in your left eye. It's like incredible, like what they were able to do. Because they worked so hard day in and day out. They got their own show in Vegas, whatever it is. He now had enough money to get surgery on his eye to not have to have that disability anymore. Because one opportunity, when you fight for an opportunity, you don't need to know what's going to come, but you just have to trust that good things are coming. So you put your head down, you get to work, and then, oh my God, it's like everything is endless. You could literally do whatever you want to do. You can accomplish whatever you want to accomplish. So by listening to this podcast, I hope you stop getting caught up in all the reasons why you can't, all the reasons why you won't, and all the reasons why you feel like it's not worth it. And I want you to start fixating on the big picture. Where do you want to go? Who do you want to be? How do you want to feel? And believe that it's possible. If you don't believe it, I'll tell you this. If you don't believe it, not taking action on it is not going to help you get there any faster. If you want to believe it, you got to take action, right? There's, I posted about this like probably like a few months ago, about like there's a belief affirmation action loop. So for some people, you want to start in believing in yourself. For others, you might need to start in affirming, I can do this, I am confident, whether you believe it or not. And then that way, and that often will help you to start to believe it. But regardless, you can't skip the action step. You got to move. You got to motivate yourself. You got to take action. And if that's the part that you're lacking, then it's going to be really challenging to do it, which is why I wanted to teach you about this visualization practice as a way to motivate yourself to do anything. So if you don't feel like working out, envision yourself lifting heavier weights. Envision yourself doing the workout. Envision yourself being done, really proud of yourself for following through with it. Okay? If you don't want to do, I don't know, writing. Maybe you're a content creator. You don't feel like writing the captions. You don't feel like creating content, whatever it is. Well, if you don't do that, what is the end of that story going to look like? And I teach people to do this with food, right? I teach people to focus on how you want to feel both now and later. You know, you can choose to continue to deprive yourself and end up binging as a result, or you can choose to learn how to eat foods in moderate amounts so that you don't end up having the like feeling like you know overate, you have the stomach ache and all that thing. Focus on how you want to feel, right? If you want to feel good and energized, what do you need to eat? How do you need to sleep? What do you need to drink to help you to feel good and energized? And if you're struggling with figuring that out, because unfortunately diet culture has made it very complicated and confusing to understand what it is that you need to eat and fuel, reach out to us. We will help you, right? But what I will tell you is that if you continue to allow these thoughts of like, I'm never going to get there, I can't do this, or I don't feel like it, or I don't want to, like, you're right. You're right. Whether you believe you can or you believe you can't, you're 100% right. I forgot who said that quote, but I know it's very popular. but it's really the truth. So whenever you're struggling to motivate yourself to do absolutely anything, I want you to envision yourself having done it. Vision yourself having accomplished it. Put that picture in your head and then take one small baby step towards doing it, right? Don't feel like working out, put your workout clothes on. Don't even worry about the other stuff. Chances are that will follow, but what's one next step? What's one baby step that's gonna help you getting closer to that vision, not further away, right? Your action is either bringing you further away or closer. You're never staying in the same spot. Every choice that you make is either bringing you further away from your goal or closer to your goal. Be mindful of that. Know that. Know that your choice is never just one choice. every choice has a reaction, which has a reaction, which has another reaction. All right. If you're new to the podcast, welcome to a positive mindset world way of thinking. If you're an old time listener, then you definitely have heard me talk about this before, just in different contexts. But at the end of the, you can do whatever you want to do. You can accomplish whatever you want to accomplish. But standing still won't help you get there. All right. So you got to take action. You got to move. You got to motivate yourself. You got to envision, what does that look like? What does that feel like? And don't, anytime that little part of self-doubt creeps in or like, I can't accomplish that, I can't do that, just let it go. Just let it go. Once you start taking action, you'll see that anything is possible. You'll see that you could do it. And although you might, I mean, maybe you don't even see it right now, but you will eventually. You definitely will eventually. So continue to stay focused on that vision. Don't give up. Never give up. If you quote unquote fail, use that failure as feedback and just push and move and get support. You don't have to do this on your own. We are here for you. We are a team of registered dietitians who can help you to follow through on your commitments, follow through on your workouts, follow through on eating balanced meals, follow through on a sleep schedule, follow through on setting boundaries. Every sort of thing that you can imagine and envision in creating a life of ultimate self-care, being the highest version of you, being the best version of you, that is what we are here to do. That is what we are here to support you to do. So if you are interested in learning how to make yourself a priority, how to get that motivation, to keep that momentum, right? Because there's one thing to get motivated, to get started, but are you consistent? Are you staying motivated? Are you building that momentum? That is what our team is here to help you to do. So if that sounds like you and you are interested to learn how to motivate yourself, the first thing, what do you need to do? You need to envision yourself applying to the program. You need to envision yourself, what does it look like if you committed to taking care of yourself for 6 solid months? What does that look like for you? How do you feel? What do you want to be? What do you want to achieve? What do you want to accomplish? Do you want to have more energy? Do you want to have balance in your eating habits? Do you want to go to a social event without stressing about what to put on and what to wear, without stressing about not eating before, or should you eat before, or when to eat before, or what to eat there, what to eat when you get home, or not eat when you get home, or to work out excessively, whatever it is, these obsessive thoughts that continuously hold you down, weigh you down, and you carry with you, that does not have to be your life. You can have a life, you vision that life of energy, of quality, of abundance, of success, of commitment, of follow through, of connection, of value. That is what you are here to be put on this earth to do. We are not meant to just live and die. Right? That's not why we're here. We're here to give our ultimate, give ourselves to others, but making sure we're also giving it back to us, right? We're here to overfill our cup so it overflows into helping others. That is what we are here to do. And if your nutrition is not being taken as a priority in a way that is aligned with both your mental and physical health, then unfortunately, you are not going to be able to do that. That's really what it comes down to, right? So you need support, you need accountability, you need structure, not restriction, and you need us, all right? And we're here to help you, and we're excited, all right? I have a team of dietitians ready to work with you one-on-one while we're also supporting you in your journey to accomplish whatever it is that you want to accomplish, but more importantly, a commitment to you, a commitment to yourself, a commitment to your family. If you are a mom or a dad, taking care of other people, you know, they deserve you being the best version of you. All right. So if anything said in this podcast episode resonated with you and you're really looking to make a real lifestyle change, you're ready to give up the diets, you're ready to just take action, to take charge, to be the best version of you, go to www.tipswithtoni.com/coaching. Watch the video about the program. If anything said there resonates, fill out that application below. Once you fill out the application, you will be emailed a copy of my schedule where you can schedule a discovery call. And that's honestly half of the battle, because then when we get on that call, we are going to go deeper into this vision. We are going to really uncover, what are your barriers? What's getting in your way? How can we overcome them? And how can we create a roadmap for you to be that incredible person that you already are, but being able to feel it? You know, you are incredible. You are beautiful. You are capable. You are confident. But unfortunately, you've allowed your diet mindset, comments from others, these false beliefs just stay with you for so long without any positive interjection, without anybody really helping you and guiding you to be able to break free of that and to get to this place of healing your relationship with food, healing your relationship with your body, finally finding balance in your eating habits, and being able to live a life that you literally dream of, okay? That is what we are here for you to do. So like I said, if you're interested, go to www.tipswithtoni.com/coaching, fill out that application, and I look forward to chatting with you on your discovery call. All right, guys, so that is it for me today. If anything said here resonated with you, go fill out that application. If maybe you're already a client or you've already worked with us in some way, share this with someone. Share the love. Let people know that it is possible. They don't have to settle for what they're settling for right now. There is a better life, a more abundant life, a more happy life, a more energy-filled life, a more connected, amazing, incredible life waiting for them. But until they get to the root of what they need to do for themselves, heal their relationship with food, unfortunately, they'll never really reach that potential. They'll never really get there. So send them this podcast. Gently remind them that there is a better way for them to live a much better, happier, healthier, more abundant way to live. All right. That is it for me today. Thank you so much for listening. As always, I'm Toni Marinucci, your registered dietitian, helping you get healthy one bite at a time.